employ Cheryl. Ugh, we did some setups off screen, but everything is basically the same. So let's do this. Alright then. Dang it, but not kind of level up I wanted. Dang it. Nice, some speed for once. Let's just keep on going. Oh, that worked. Wow. Did not expect that to work at 21%. That'll be good, since Cheryl can't really do anything. Dang it. Okay then. Dang it. I love Blade Lords. At least she got some magic. That'll work for now like that. Okay, well, at least getting through to him. We're just gonna have to continue to go forward straight since, yeah. Benedict is honestly pretty useless. Dang it. Oh. Nice. I'm not gonna need a steel sword for now. Let's get Link the longbow since we're not gonna need it for the others. And then we'll start moving the others this way. We're at least slowly making a battle formation. Badly done one, but hey, beggars can't be choosers. Then we can't forget about Cheryl. And then, as we get straight through it. Nice. An armor slayer. We won't need one this chapter. Wrong unit, sorry. Gonna have to use up an Excalibur. Nice. Let's hope Weird Eyes gets a good level up. He did! I already have a Steel Axe, so we're good on that. Takes care of that, and then we'll start. Might as well start. Might as well start recruiting people and getting different ideas. You do gotta love that the creator of this mod, he made sure they were prepared. It's like Order of the Crimson Arm, where they either they have both ways to counter their weapon triangle disadvantage. We'll take Felipe with them, Benedict with them, and then the rest will go this way. Then we can't forget Cheryl, unfortunately. Nice. That's what you get framing for a girl. Unfortunately, it wasn't a good level up, but hey. Going this way now. Nice, the chest key. And then with that, we should take out that druid right there. Switch out his arm into an axe and block this way right here. And then we just gotta get slowly but surely straight through there. I'm wasting too much resources in trying to recruit a character. Because you know Ruby's gotta be recruitable. Dang it. Oh well, bro. Dang! You don't anger a blade lord. Okay. Looks like, yeah, you can talk to her. Dang, Carlisle's very straightforward. Alright then. Alright then. That's one way to recruit. The downside is it's best to get him away, get her away since well, she's a Pegasus Knight. A We also had to get Nate away. Nice. Let them use their attack options right there while we heal. And then since O'Clara already took out that enemy right there, we'll slowly get him back up to there. That we can ambush. Yes, these two have full health, and there's no way these guys are gonna take those two out. Unless they crit. And we gotta get out of here as soon as possible since, once again, Estar is on his way. I still question how a barricade can block a blessed sword that makes all stats max, but hey. Okay, good. They're aiming for my lord. We gotta kill these guys. It's a good thing we got your boy Tim Teo right there. And that's a good level up right there. As well as a chest key. Looks like Tim Teo's gonna be our chest boy. Nah, let's not play safe. Let's just kill. Yeah, kill like that. And then with that, we'll slowly be sure to be done. The star should be appearing soon. That's why I'm trying to get everybody out of here. Make sure she's a... Okay. Now all we gotta do is move Claudio. Which is what we're probably doing right now. I guess that's why he gave us the armor slayers. Dang, Claudio's too heavy. So the best idea for now is just heal and get straight to there. There he is. Dang, that was worthless to get that armor slayer. Okay then. They definitely didn't because he got caught. His name's Ramon with that. It's like a afro of Cosmo Yuki from Ideon. Yeah, let's get straight to it. That boss shouldn't move, but you never know. The good thing is, we didn't give him a quick passageway. As you notice, it's gonna take him a couple of turns just to get straight up to us. Then again, what about that sword? Okay, good. It would've been evil if he made it had like two. The good thing is, you notice, is he's gotta go through there, so it'll take about 5 to 10 turns. So while we're doing that, we're gonna be doing stuff. Okay, it's gonna aim for her. Come on. Why didn't it name for the Pegasus Knight? Nice. Thank you. with this we should be able to finish him. No, that'll make mincemeat out of him. Oh, amateur. Amateur. True source becomes one with the magic realm, yielding all sense of self. Oh, snap. Oh, it's a Nosferatu, that's why. Oh, great. We'll just start with healing for now. We'll probably move Link out of the way for now and then unlock those treasure chests and heal Link. He's not gonna be able to move out of there because the gate's right there. And he's a boss. Killer Alliance, nice. Energy rating, nice. Now let's see what this one has. Blazer. I'm guessing that's his personal weapon. Okay, we're gonna have to finish off now. Oh, dang. Why did we get criticaled? It was like, dear God, why? How do you critical Nosferatu? Okay, now we gotta finish him off, actually. She was pissed! Nice. And the last chest. 3,000 gold, just what I needed. Let's get out of here. Let's just get out of here. Real quick, how far is he? And all chests have been opened, so yeah. Ironically, I don't use that guy. Don't use him either. Wait, what? What? He said boo. You gotta respect this comedy. Why would you yell that out? He's got honor. So it's a dragon. Alright then. Sorry for not much talk, that was quite the chapter. Regardless, we managed to beat it, get through it before Estar himself appeared. We managed to survive. Kinda happy I didn't lose anyone that time. But yeah. Thank you all for watching. Till the next part, goodbye.